gestational diabetes, we could talk about the complications of gestational. So what's the issue with gestational diabetes? Why do we worry? So there's a very, the ambient glucose levels are higher, so the baby can see more sugars, and that baby can become bigger in utero. So one of the complications, because they get more calories because of all that sugar that they don't really need, but the sugar is crossing the placenta and feeds the baby. And so one of the issues the babies can get, they get macrosomia, which means large babies at birth. So delivery is difficult. These one might require more C-section, and they might have more issues at the time of delivery for the baby. Also, these babies, they're so much used to this free supply of sugar coming from the mother that when they actually come out and they're delivered, their sugar actually interestingly drops. So they get hypoglycemia because they're waiting for more sugar to come and it's not coming, but their liver is premature and can't make sugar. So they're big babies, but they behave like preemies and little babies where they can make sugar because they never needed to make sugar. They had all this sugar around that they were utilizing in pregnancy. So the complications of gestational diabetes is baby getting low sugar after birth. And they have to feed them. They might even get seizures if they go very low. It's having a baby that's very big. You know, they can come out at the weight of over 9 pounds, 10 pounds at delivery. And they have high rates of getting jaundice and yellow, these babies, again, because they're kind of premature in their development of other parts of their body. So those are the main complications. Babies who have gestational diabetes don't get other complications that babies of other mothers get with high sugars. So because gestational diabetes only happens at the end of pregnancy. Now, we also have women who get pregnant where they already have diabetes. So they already have type 1 or type 2 diabetes. So the baby's gonna see sugars from day 1 till the end. So all through the 9 months, they get other complications. So not only they get the gestational diabetes complications, they can also get other congenital anomalies where they can get holes in the heart or other things, because at the time the fetus is just being formed at the beginning, the sugar also interferes there. So there's multiple issues. But saying all that, that does not mean that pregnancy should not happen with diabetes. You just need to have a good team to help you. You can get the sugars tightly controlled before you get pregnant and go through pregnancy with no complications. Same with gestational diabetes. You need early diagnosis, you get screened by your obstetrician, they'll send you in to see endocrinologists and a team of diabetic nurse educators and dietitians. We follow them weekly or every 2 weeks for the rest of pregnancy. And majority, over 90% of our patients with gestational diabetes never have any complications.